afraid I'm going to have to search you before letting you in. The only weapons allowed on the premises are the ones we're selling. It should... There.
The bosses are having a meeting. You'll have to wait until it's over.
Mr. Soren, please get to the point. The second half of your payment is late, and I want to know why.
Keep your hands where we can see them. My associates and I have decided that we wish to renegotiate the terms of our deal.
Might I ask for what reason? The shipment was delivered. The guns were tested before leaving this facility.
Regardless, we feel that the quality of the weapons is below expectation and hope to adjust the price accordingly.
Ah, I think I understand what the issue here is. Excuse me for a moment, would you? Do it. Never break faith with the Van Graffs, Mr. Soren. I expect you'll have the rest of our payment ready tomorrow morning. Okay, everyone. Show's over. Back to work. Welcome to the Silver Rush, where only top-of-the-line energy weapons can be found. What can I do for you? Of course. Welcome to the Silver Room. It just so happens a position opened up recently. We currently need another body to guard the entrance outside. Think you can handle that? Wonderful. I already have a man outside who can show you the ropes and get you set up. His name is Simon. He's been with the family for years, so listen to what he says and follow his instructions.
We're watching you closely.
Welcome to the Silve. Oh, crap. Don't tell me you're my new guard. Well, no time for pleasantries. I've got your gear right here, but let's see if you can follow instructions. You'll be covering the other side of the door there. Take your position while I get your stuff out. Good. Look up. Around and get a feel for where customers and risks can enter and exit the area while I get your gear ready. Okay, now let's get you geared up. First, your armor. Standard issue is your run-of-the-mill combat armor, with a nice dark coat of paint for both brand recognition and sheer intimidation value. Next, your weapon. Guards are required to use rifles. Anything lighter compromises your combat effectiveness. Anything heavier and people are too scared to come in the door. What's your preference, laser or plasma? Good choice. I prefer laser-based weapons myself, but the boss lady says she wants at least one guard using a plasma rifle. Says the lightning bits draw in more people. Whatever. Now that you're equipped, a quick word on the job at hand. In a nutshell, we're here to keep the riffraff away. Drunks, punks, and capless vermin are to be turned away. Potential customers are to be permitted normal entrance. That is, after we pat them down for weapons. An unarmed man is a lot less likely to try to steal something with several armed guards around. Don't start any fights. I don't care if some jet junkie just assaulted your mother. We're here to promote violence elsewhere, not start it here. Lastly, don't abandon your post. We're getting paid to stand next to this door, not talk to someone down the street or head to the casino. That goes double for any thoughts of splitting with that gear. Every now and then, some young punk thinks he can run off with Van Graaff property. Trust me, the rifle and armor are nice, but they're not worth your life. Other than that, relax. There's usually some eye candy coming and going from the Wrangler over there at some point, so the view's not too bad. Settle in. You've got some hours left before your shift ends. There comes a winner. I'll let you handle this one.
Hi there. Is this where I can pick up a laser gun? Sounds like a stupid policy to me.
Good. Stick to the rules. Another one coming. You're on.
Hi. I was, in the area and thought I'd stop by to look at your weapons. Can I go in? Fine by me.
He's clean. See? Not so hard, is it? Heads up. Looks like we got another customer.
Howdy. I just done broke the bank over at the Wrangler there and thought I might peruse your fine wares. Maybe lighten my purse a little? Now hold on here. I'm not packing any heat. Ain't my word good enough for you? I suppose it's all right, if there's no other choice.
He's clean.
See? Told you so.
Looks like that guy's headed this way. Don't screw it up.
Hey, looking for something to replace my old revolver. Mind if I head in? That's not really necessary, is it? I already told you I got this here revolver, right? Damn, I knew this wasn't gonna work.
Now what? What the hell do you suppose that was about? Help me clean this up. No one's gonna want to shop here with the corpse out front. Crap. This I do not need today. Keep your head straight, rookie. Things are about to get interesting.
Hey, Simon. How's it hanging? Looks like you've got a little helper today.
What can I say? Business has been good lately. We can afford the help.
Good to hear, buddy. So is the boss lady in?
You know she is. Why don't you go in and say hi?
Nah, I got some rounds to run. But do pass along that I'm always thinking of her. Actually, I got a better idea. Make the new hire tell her. You'll do that for me, won't you? That's a good dog. Well, I'm out of here. Later, Simon.
Way to keep your head, rookie. There's hope for you yet. It's just about closing time. Let's go see the boss about getting paid. Oh, I'm gonna need the rifle and armor back. Boss's orders.
We're watching you closely.
Simon's been telling me how it went. Let's do a quick recap. You kept away the undesirables, patted down the rest for weapons, and kept your cool. That is to say, you performed as instructed. Simon was impressed, and so am I. So you get a small bonus with your normal pay. Unfortunately, I found someone else with a little more experience, and he'll take over the position starting tomorrow. However, another task has come up that I could use some help with, assuming you're still interested in making some money. There's a deal that we've been working on for a while now, and the buyer would like a sample of our weapons. I need you to run a package out to a discreet location that the client has chosen. Sound good? Good. Here's the package. I'll mark the location on your map. The buyer said they'd be in town for quite a while, so there's no rush. That said, try not to dawdle. This client could mean big money for us, which naturally means big money for you.
We're watching you closely.
Hello.
Are you the Van Graaff's emissary? Don't play games with me. The question was just a formality. Now, do you have what we requested? I wasn't informed there was to be an exchange on my part. What are you talking about? Such a thing is possible. I've been out in the field for some time. Fine. This should cover your grievance. Now, the package, if you will. Ah. Then our business is concluded. Tell your superiors that we will contact them shortly.
Welcome back. Did you have news for me, or are you just here for the guns? And? Don't leave me in suspense. What was their reaction? Good. Good. Here's your payment. If you'll excuse me, I have some thinking to do. Oh, Jean-Baptiste was talking about a matter earlier that he needs help with. I volunteered you. See him for the details.
Welcome to the Atomic Wrangler. What can I get you? I have some work I need handled. Back before we instituted the caps up front rule, we used to allow customers tabs. Well, needless to say, a few customers snuck out without paying their bills. We need someone to collect. The job would pay a percentage. If you bring all their debts back, we'll give you a cut of each. 25% is more than fair. It would add up to 150 caps if you bring them all in. All right, 50-50 it is. But you better bring back all of the caps. If we hear you crossed us, the next bounty hunter will be coming for you. Great. There are three people who need to be tracked down. A real mixed basket of fruits. Their names are Grex, Santiago, and Lady Jane. Grex is a bit cracked, but mostly harmless. Just don't mention anything about his lazy eye. He owes 138 caps and should still be around Freeside. Lady Jane fancies herself a high roller, but she's just another dirtbag NCR prospector. I'm not sure where to find her. I hear she's run goods for the followers of the apocalypse in the past, but other locals might know more. She owes us 250 caps. Santiago is a suave son of a bitch, but a total pansy when it comes to fisticuffs. He owes 212 caps and should be around Freeside as well. Anything else you need? Later.
Hello. Lovely to meet you. In that case, I suppose you're here to collect. I apologize, but I simply do not have enough caps on me to cover the debt. If someone were to recover my caravan from that cave, I could easily pay in full, but who would bother with such a mess? Damn! I didn't want to hand over all of my caps because I won't have enough to get home to California. Here, take it all. I'll find my way home one way or another.
Hey, man. Can you spare a few caps? Whoa! Yeah. I guess the Garrett sent you after me? Look, I've got the caps right here. Just don't hurt me. Okay. Here. That's everything I've got except the clothes on my back. I'm sorry about this. I won't. Thanks for not killing me.
How's it going? How are you today? Santiago is fabulous. Santiago does not owe anyone. Santiago is a Freeside VIP. Sir, Santiago does not know what he has done to offend, but he can explain everything. I didn't think she was upset enough to have me killed. Here are the capsail. I do the Santiago act to get out of paying for services every once in a while. I didn't think it could possibly get me killed. Later.
My eye on you.
Welcome back. What can I get you? I don't care how you handled those lumps of human refuse, but you got the job done. We need you to hunt down another person. That son of a bitch McCaffrey stole a ton of caps and ran off to Vegas. I guess the fact that we farmed out his usual work to you pissed him off. No one steals from the Garrett twins. If you can kill that bastard and bring back as much as you can, you'll be paid very well. Good. Just stop on back when he's dead and you'll be rewarded handsomely. Bring his hat as proof of the kill. Talk to you later.
If you're looking for guns, talk to Mick. Otherwise, I've got a nice selection of general supplies. I only offer services if the king gives the okay. Impress him, and we can talk. All right. Yeah, I've got a little side business going. What I'm about to share with you does not leave this room, huh? Over the years, I've gradually perfected my craft to the point of perfection. No one can distinguish between my work and the real thing. What I'm referring to is passports. If you've got the caps, I can whip up a strip passport which will fool even the most well-trained eye. Hey, if you're interested and have the caps, they go for 500. Any less, and it ain't worth the risk of getting caught. What do you say? You game? I like your style, kid. But the best I can do is meet you halfway. 375 caps, and we can call it a deal. There you go. Come back anytime.
Welcome to Mick and Ralph's. If you need guns, I'm your man. For general supplies and other services, see my partner Ralph. Why? Do you work for one of the casinos? In that case, yes, I do. Follow me. Like I always say, a polite society is an armed society.